Mathematics is a language. Let's see. It's telling short stories through formulas. If you can understand, if you know. Like if I tell you right now in Turkish, canım arkadaşlarım, iyi ki geldiniz, sizi çok seviyorum. You miss out on that beauty. If you learn, if you crack the code, then you know. So I wanted my students to know this language. So I start creating hands-on experiments that turn into photos and a math photo album. So, but before I introduce my mathematics photo album, what's in it? May I ask your help to demonstrate an important mathematics concept with sound? Would you please all give me a snap per second? Awesome, sounds great. Thank you. Now, would you please all give me two claps per second? Two claps. Awesome. Thank you. I mean, what just happened? I got my free claps, yeah, at the beginning of my talk. No, that wasn't the purpose. You just demonstrated important concept of slope. When you give me a snap, snap, one snap, you did slope of one. You just did, oh, sorry. You just did y equal 1x. So when you did one snap, you show me y equal 1x. When you did clap twice, you show me y equal 2x. So this is my Mr. Grumpy, I call him. And when we think about a slope, we often think like climbing mountains. And it could be mountains, but most of the time it's not. Slope is a ratio, it's per something. So it could be simple as that instead of climbing mountains. Like it could be height and time. But most of the time I could do simply, like my Mr. Grumpy does here, walk here, like you did. I can show you one step per second. I can go one step per second, one step. Just to show you a slope of one. And all I have to do is increase my rate to show you a slope of two, which is y equal to x. I can go two step and two step. That will show you. It's not too complicated. What I mean is we could do as parents, as educators, this is not gonna cost you anything. You don't have to go to the store, waste your energy and time. It's something you can do with sounds and steps. Easy enough, but not everybody thinks it's easy enough. I found this shirt online, it's on me. It says I can do area of this and area of that, but when it comes to slope equation, I cannot do y equal ymx plus b is the slope equation. And it says I draw my line in here. I mean, there is a pun on the line in here. Because line is a slope, and line is also, I draw my line, it's too hard, that's it. Is it really a nightmare? Let me this time show you with a negative slope. I got three pillows right here. If I wanted to show you a negative slope, I start with something I have. Then I have to lose it. And if I want to show you slope of negative one, I have to lose one pillow at a time. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that. Here, catch my babies. 1 second. Another second I'm lost. Here's another one. Here's another one I lost. So I lost my pillows. How do I write this? Look at this beautiful story. 3 minus 1x. It's telling you, if you just see this formula, it's telling you I started with something with three. It could be $3, whatever it is. But you are losing one at a time, per something, one. So it's telling you, you can immediately imagine the story is telling you. It's going down, it's a line going down, you can imagine. I thought we could do this, we could do, we ought to ask, we have a really great special education kids, and they deserve better, which I love the math books. We can supplement them. This type of experiments, photos, and make them understand the language. And when I wanted to do that, we could also use lots of food, which that's what I did in my mathematics for all of them. I used lots of food. I used anything you can think of, berries, my goodness, what's it? Pistachios, raisins, you think you're safe with raisins, and chocolate. And chocolate is the trouble one because one time one of my students go ahead and right in the middle of the experiment, he goes, he takes a whole handful of chocolate and just all gone. And I said, oh my God, I didn't call a mistake. I called a happy little accident. You know, it's good. So what you can, what you're looking at right now is the y equal. I'm starting with two berries, and I'm increasing with three berries. So start with two, increments of three. Increments of three indicates slope. It's three. But this is not like a poster puzzle. There's a question mark where the slope should be in the equation. So you can guess that three is a slope, you had it right. All you have to do in the poster, peel it, peel the question mark, right underneath, you can see it says three. Just like in here. And you can see the size of it. Look at the hand. It's like half my size poster. And what else I did? I did photos of golden ratio. Golden ratio and Fibonacci numbers are everywhere in nature. And it's your, it is in your ears. Those numbers, they're like spiraling. It's in galaxies. It's in water going down. It's in flower petals. And look at the size. This is my living room, by the way. And then look at that. That is a huge. I created this with sticky notes. You can see the size compared to my ukulele. And this poster I made, it tells the large number law is a law that if you repeat an experiment, the probability of experimental probability will get close to the theoretical probability. So the more you repeat, you'll catch theory. Is it true? Look at it. When I use only a couple pennies in the first photo, my probability of getting tail, it turned out to be zero. When I use a little bit more pennies, it was 75%. So I'm thinking, oh, what's going on? Is the theory wrong? The theory said you should get 50% of the time tail. But what happens, wait, when you get more and more pennies, like on the last photo, 100 pennies, your experimental probability will around 49% to 50%. It's extremely close to theory. This is what the casinos operate on. Basically, if you are on a roulette machine, your chance of winning, what is it? Depends on which country you're in, 47 to 48%. And you keep playing hours and hours, or more people playing, you're increasing experiment again and again and again. So you'll definitely, you're gonna win 47%. It means most of the time you're gonna lose. Here's another thing I did with my students. First, I'll start with triangular paper. I want them to understand this language, saying interior angles of something, like triangles. They usually memorize, and they say, Miss Malone, what is this? What was it? And I told them, get into some pieces of paper, triangle, take the edges, put them together, see what you see. But this time, I give them a cheese. So cheese is easy. Cheese are easy to construct. So they can see it's 180 degrees. So they don't have to memorize, they can associate. Another thing I did, which they love, is their favorite chocolate. We teach them rectangular, interior angles of rectangle is 360. Is it really 360? Get the corners off, put them together, you can see it's 360. Right here is my imperfect pentagon, banana bread. I tinkle with a corner, supposed to be a pentagon, but it wasn't a perfect pentagon. So you can do this, take the corners and put them together and see what it's gonna be. Even what they love the most is the Crunchwrap. If you're eating with your loved ones around the table, a Crunchwrap, you can see, oh, hey, I'll rip off the corners and see. You can do this at home, even with your loved ones and your kids. And what happened? I started with a triangle. I went all the way up to hexagon. And then I realized the more edge I add, the more edges, it's getting rounder and rounder. If you notice, my shape is getting rounder and rounder. So when I went to local Aldi and I saw, what is going on in Aldi? Everything is rounded. Sounds like nature is preferring rounded shapes. Look at those watermelons, grapes, oranges, onions. It's like anything wasn't rounded. One thing wasn't rounded there on that photo was the human-made box. Then I looked at our classrooms. Well, look at those ceilings, look at those chairs, and look at all these floors, everything, cabinets. They're rectangle or a square. We seem like prefer rectangles and squares, and the nature seems like prefer rounded shapes. Even if you get a metal with rounded, if you melt it, you know, you'll get rounded shapes. Then I said, why is this? Probably we are easy to produce, easy to stack up. It's probably it is. Then I remember my time in Sydney Opera House in Australia. It's beautiful. That's my fridge magnet you're seeing. those shells, it's like orange pieces. It's so hard to construct. So this famous architect, Danish architect, he had to build this giant metal sphere. Then he had to cut all these pieces, like a cutting a piece of orange. It was pretty tough, but he did it, and it's really famous, it's beautiful. So mathematics is in the nature, it's everywhere. And we could make our special education kids, which they deserve, they're lovely, I love them, make their life a little better, a little easier. Teach them the language, anything we can think of. And we can supplement our math books, which I love. I love the math books. They are a great source. But there is still room for improvement. We could make some hands-on experiments and take photos. We can supplement our math books. We can do a better job. So I'm going to, now you could do actually, when you go to your loved ones, you could blow them a kiss. Since knowing what is a slope, one kiss in 3 seconds. One-third slope. One kiss in 3 seconds. So I'm going to go ahead and do right now. 1, 2, 3 seconds. And 1, 2, and 3 seconds. Thanks for coming.